Night breezes seem to whisper, I love you. Birds singing in the sycamore tree. Dream a little dream of me. Say nighty night and kiss me. Just hold me tight and tell me you'll miss me. While I'm alone and blue as can be, dream a little dream of me.
Stars fading, but I linger on, dear.
Oh, how you linger on.
Still craving your kiss.
How you crave my kiss.
Now I'm longing to linger till dawn, dear. Just saying this.
Give me a little kiss, sweet dreams, till sunbeams find you. Sweet dreams that leave all worries behind you. But in your dreams, whatever they be, dream a little dream of me.
Buzz, 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 buzz,
buzz,
fading, but I linger on, dear. Still craving your kiss. Yeah, I'm longing to linger till dawn, dear.
Loud. If she is not going to work with me, I'm going to turn her off. Alexa, turn your volume to 1. All right, that's better. Okay, hello, hello, hello. How is everyone doing? Hi, Aiden. Come on in. Give it some likes. Give it some shares. We're going to get into shadow work. And I wanted to just check in. I was having a pretty good day. A lot of, I would say, epiphanies, connecting the dots, is how I put it in our Genic family group page today. And doing some, I'm so glad you're here. Yay. You know, I haven't been on for a while because I was sick. I'm still healing right now. But I could not even get out of bed. I was just, not feeling well. And I have no idea what it was. We tested for COVID. It wasn't that. I haven't been on. So I'm so glad that you are here. Again, we'll just let everybody roll in, double tap, share, say where you're coming from. And thank you. Well, I missed you guys. I love our family connection here on TikTok and our soul family. I love how we have an opportunity to connect with one another here on TikTok, and we can have whole other conversations that you wouldn't find on any other app. I love that. Florida's in the house. Hello, Beth. Thank you so much for coming in. Come on in, get comfortable. I want you to grab a notebook if you're ready to do some shadow work today. I'm working through the shadow work journal. I am a shaman and I have done a crap load of shadow work. I can't even tell you how much, and I can tell you that there's always new layers to every piece of shadow you've ever worked on. Every time I'm like, oh yeah, got that, figured that out, nailed it, boom, out of nowhere. Like I said with my other video, like, life is going to come and get you. It's going to get you when it's ready. Hey, Wisconsin. Yes, beautiful. So there's two ways that I look at shadow work. One as being a shaman, and what that means is when you see a repetitive problem showing up in your life over and over and over again, you're going to slow down. This is what you're going to start working on. You're like, wait a minute. That guy that I dated had this in common with that guy that I dated. And now the one that I'm also not wanting to be in the relationship with also has these same features. Maybe it is something that's attached to me and the way that I'm communicating, like outwardly showing what I feel comfortable with. You know, this is what shadow work is. It's digging in. It's understanding those layers inside you and being able to bring that to the surface. So that's one form of shadow work where we dig in. If we start seeing patterns show up in our life, we start tracking them and we start figuring out what the common denominator is. And most of the time, I promise you, it is you, my friend. I'm not going to lie. When you're saying, it's your fault. You did it. We're growing up now. We know that we chose to put ourselves in certain positions. You know, when I got myself into the domestic violent relationship that I put myself into, at the time I would have said, well, he's the one who has the problem. You know, when I went through Al-Anon, my father went to AA when I was growing up, and I went to Al-Anon, and one of the teachers said to me, who do you think is sicker? Do you think it's the drug addict or the alcoholic? Or do you think it's the one who's enabling it? Like, we're aware that it's happening, right? But we choose to keep going back. So why do we keep going back? Why do you choose to go back? Why did I choose to go back? That is shadow work. That means I got to slow down and I got to look at why this keeps happening and realizing that I'm the common denominator. It's not happening to anybody else. It keeps happening to me. But why? Have you slowed down and asked why? When is the last time that you slowed down and asked why? Or do you just go, oh, that's the way life is. Yes, there it is, Aiden. Because we accept what we think we deserve. You only deserve what you think you deserve. So why would you say that you deserve the worst thing in the world? Anybody at all? Hey there, hubby. There's my lovely husband, Nikki Scorpio, in the house. Okay, so let's get where we left off. We're going to do review real fast, so make sure that you got that lovely notebook. Go ahead and pull it out. Or if you have had a chance to get the book, which right here, I'm going to start it out right at the beginning of the live stream so you guys can all see it and be able to get it for yourself. Oh my goodness, I'm getting confused and lost. Okay. Let's go. Will it show up? Boop, 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 ba-doop. There it is. I found it. Okay. So here is the shadow book. Right here. If you do not have it yet, you're going to get a notebook and you're going to pull it out and you're going to go, time to do some shadow work with Shama Mama. Okay. So we're going to go over a quick review real fast where if you see here, what is in our unconscious that we are not looking at? I fall for people potential. I don't think it's on Amazon. It is right here. It's pinned in my shop right now. I'll unpin it real fast and repin it so it should pop up so you can catch your attention. But this right here is what we're going to begin on. So if you don't have the paper yet or this book, you're going to go get a piece of paper right now and we're going to get into that shadow work because why? You are worth it. It's time to find out why these patterns keep happening in your life. Why, you know, it's not up to anybody else to do the work, by the way. I don't know where we all got the gumption that we thought that, oh, someone else will do it. Someone else would do it. Do you realize that that's the pattern in the world? Like, oh, someone else will do it. There is a certain amount of people right now that will step up and do the work in this world, and you can see this in the government, and you can see it in your personal life right now. I guarantee it. There will be a certain amount of people, and I want you right now with me, with the Shama Mama, with our whole soul family. I want you to choose you right now. I want you to realize that you deserve to be happy. And the only one that gets to choose that is you. Nobody else goes into these thoughts. Not one person can go into your mind. I can't go into world in gold. I can't go into Amanda's mind. I can't go into Nana. I can't go into any of your minds and say, hey, this is what you're going to do. Now, if you're under 18 and you're still living with your parents, I would say 16 and up, because after 16, you can file to be on your own. If you are in a spot where you cannot choose your own thoughts right now, if you don't have a say in your choices, but for all the rest of you and all of you in the back too, I'm talking to you right now. Guess what? You have this power too. The only thing you can control in your entire life. You can't control what the weather's going to look like. You can't control person's going to show up in your life tomorrow. You don't know if there's going to be a car accident. You don't know what is going to change tomorrow. You can't even rely on the person that's sitting next to you that for sure they're going to be there tomorrow. None of these things you can control. No matter how hard you try, and some reason we get into this delusion where we think that we can still control this. And I'm going to tell you where that comes from. So stick with me, because we're going to do the shadow work. And again, if you have not gotten the journal yet, we're going to be doing these on my lives for quite a bit. I love this. I am a shaman. Shadow work is what saved my life coming out of domestic violence. I thought my life was over. I didn't know what I was going to get. I had no money to my name. I didn't have a car to my name. I left with just the clothes on my back, because I knew the way that I was being treated was not okay. I don't know how I got myself in that position, but I did. Bottom line, I chose to go into it. There had to be a lot of red flags along the way. A lot. And don't you sit here and tell me the situation that you're in right now that you didn't create it. Don't even try. I'm not going to take it. If you still want to sit in that space, then you got to go. If you want to learn why you keep doing this, I want you to double tap right now and I want you to share. So bring more of the soul family in and make sure you're following. If you want to go deeper in your personal story, if this isn't enough for you, guess what? I got some retrograde specials right now. We have a group class coming up that you can sign up for. It's all in the link in my bio. There's so many different ways that you can be a part of this. If this free version is not enough for you, but if not, if that's all you can afford right now, is your cute little self can just show up right here and get it free right now with me. And you can save up to get this shadow book. And then you can save up to do a session with me. But right now you're here because you're choosing who? Who? Everybody write it down. Write it down. You're choosing who right now by staying here with me and getting this going. You're choosing. So I want you to say, I am choosing. What's the rest of that sentence? Me. There it is, Ashley. Ashley, go. Book a free session with me where it says 15 minutes with Shama Mama Squad. Good job in answering, okay? And I'm going to give away more tonight if you're paying attention, because I want to meet you. I want to meet you. I'm going to give you 30 minutes and we're going to sit and we're going to connect and I'm going to send you homework. And then you can come back on the live and we could do even more work until you believe in yourself so much that you go out there and you make the life that you want. Because honey, buddy, all of you, you're the only one that can do that. You've got the power. You have the keys. And I'm going to show you where the gems are hiding inside you right now. You've put them into the unconscious. You've put them into the shadows. You put them into the darkness. Nikki and I have been thinking about this a lot for just in ourselves too. And you're going to hear about this on our podcast as we're recording it right now. You're going to realize that there has to be a point where you have to stop playing the game. You've had enough review. You have gone through so many, you don't even know how to predict the end of the story right now, don't you? Don't you? You know exactly how the story is going to go. Oh, if I go do that, then this is going to show up. Well, of course it is, because that's how you think it is, and that's what you focus on. But guess what? You also have the power to turn it the other way around. You can go a whole new direction. You just got to be stubborn enough, strong enough, smart enough, trustworthy enough. I don't know. There's so many different things that you could identify with that to step into your power. And you got to figure out what's blocking you. So let's get in there. First thing we're going to look at is habits and patterns. That's how I opened this. Again, write down unconscious. On my unconscious side, I have habits and patterns. Well, what do you mean by this, Miss Jen? Miss Shama Mama? What I mean by this like, just like I said when I opened this live stream, are you someone right now that's in a really bad relationship and you're like, how did I get here right now? Anybody? Like my son said right here, I'm going to try to pin him. Yeah. He said, take notes. Get that notebook out. That's my son right there if you want to give him a follow. He's helping moderate with my husband right now. Habits and patterns. What pattern or habit are you seeing in your life? Maybe it's with a relationship. I'm going through a divorce and healing. There's one right there. Let me see what's going on with yours. Any other habits and patterns that you see in your life? Anybody else? Write it in here. Okay, I think I fixed your settings, babe. Okay. It's just glitchy. Okay. All right, back to focus. We're focusing. I got distracted for a second. What else? What else? Divorce and healing. Okay, how about I eat the same foods all the time, but I know they're not good for me? Oh, but I can't afford it because I'm on a budget. You know, one thing I noticed the other day is that the foods that are actually healthier for you are starting to become cheaper because money has become like doubled what it's worth, right? Like it costs me, was it $3 now for the dollar cheeseburger at McDonald's if I were to go there? But it could cost me $3 to go get products where I can make veggie burgers. You know, I could go get a veggie burger. I could get something healthier. Or I can just make a salad for like $4 for a packet. You make excuses. So that could be another way that you see habits and patterns. How about fixing people? Anybody of you fixers in here, codependent people? Like, oh, I see your problem and I'll help you fix that right now. And then as soon as that relationship blows up because they're tired of your control and you're tired of them just not ever changing, when do you look at yourself? Or do you go and find somebody else? That's another habit or pattern that could be showing up. Do you go to a substance to not feel emotions anymore? Anybody? How about this one? Self-sabotage. Well, this is the way it's always been. I don't get any better than this. This is just the way it is. Anybody say things like that in here? This is a great question right here. Can you fix someone who's not ready to be fixed? Let me ask you something. I want you to answer this honestly, and anybody else can answer. Congratulations, Aiden, on recently quit drinking. That is amazing. Everybody tell Aiden congratulations and that we're proud of him and keep up the good work. Okay, you cannot fix somebody who's not ready. Imagine somebody trying to come and fix you right now. What is your reaction to them? Anybody? What would be your reaction if I came into your life and I was your mom or I was your sister or I was your best friend? And you are also a fixer. Most of the time we attract very similar people from us because even alcoholics have a fixer attitude, a lot of them. And then if they can't use that as a gift, then they go into the anger and depression even further. But we all have that, like we just don't want to hurt people's feelings in common. That's all common with being a fixer. So that is also a habit. It's a habit of ignoring you. You have a habit of ignoring you. Did you ever hear of, you know, you got to put your oxygen first. You got to put it on first before you can take care of anyone else. How are you going to love somebody when you don't even know how to love yourself? I mean, that's a mystery. You got to figure that out before you go and go out to the world and you don't even know how to love. I heard that a person isn't attached to a type, but attached to the habit of what they use. They're used to. That's my opinion. That's what I'm saying right now, right? I didn't keep picking the bad boys because I wanted to be hurt. I picked the bad boys because I could fix them. I saw they just needed love and attention, and I can make their sandwiches, and I can help keep their house clean, and blah, 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 and that'll make them feel better, because that's what their mom did. That's all they need. Oh, they work so hard, they need my assistance, too, so that way they know they're loved. Bull crap. Excuse my language. Like, we're not playing that game anymore. I used to play that game. But once I started realizing, wait a minute, this is the same cycle over and over and over again. There's a loop happening here. And can't I just step off the loop? Well, yeah, you can. But we don't know what's on the other side. You're going to have to let go of that control. Ooh. Well, I know what's happening over here. And maybe I'll just put up with it a little bit longer because that feels safer. Anybody else recognize that? I finally chose to let go of the control and go, well, it's got to be better than this. I hit so low and being treated the way that I was treated, not being able to enjoy any of my pregnancies, being abused through all of it, having to go through court with one of them. I certainly didn't think I chose that. But you know what? Once I started doing the work, once I started going in and seeing the habits and seeing the repetitive patterns, you know what? I saw a lot of problems that I had with my father. Showed up in my relationships. Ah, the original root. And God knows what other lifetime it's attached to. The problem was I didn't know how to stand up for myself. The problem was I was told over and over again, you're just doing this to get attention. You know what? You're to be seen and you're not to be heard. You know what? You're not the adult here. You're the child. How many else heard these sentences or sentences like them in your life? Do you know each time that was said to you, you kept denying yourself to be heard? Oh, they're right. Oh, my problems aren't as big as their problems. Oh my God. The way that what they went through is way worse than mine. Why would I want... Mine's not even a problem compared to yours. The lies. The lies we told ourselves. The lies we're probably still telling ourselves. It's not true. It's not true. You, my love, deserve to be heard. That's one of my favorite parts of my job. One day I realized that while I was sitting and listening to someone who I connected with, the deep empathy from what I went through with my abuse story and how I was raised. And I had empathy for what they were going through. I understood. I said, you know what? I get the job to listen now and to remind them how good they're doing. Yes, we always want to do better, but you know what? Just be proud of where you're at right now. When's the last time that you slowed down and looked at who you were and how far you've come? When's the last time you've done that? Selfishness and self-love have been a struggle because the line between the two is confusing for me. You know what, Britt? That is so... honestly written. Please go book 15 seconds with me. It says free 15 minutes for Shama Mama Squad. And if you would like free 15 minutes with me every month, just right here, subscribe, be part of the Shama Mama Squad. When you go to the link in my bio, go to my calendar and you'll see free session 15 minutes for Shama Mama Squad. I would love to meet you, and I want to help you go into this space you're just opening up and being so honest with us here with the Shama Mama Squad and the Soul Family. Selfishness and self-love has been a struggle because the line between the two is confusing for her, is what she's saying. So let's break this down just a little bit. Let's look at that. I want you to answer these questions. What is the common habit in your life right now? What do you see, Britt? I'm going to pin that one more time because we're going to work through this together, because Britt is not the only one who feels this way, right? There's other people in here. What is a habit, Britt, that you see? It's a lot to type so fast. Take your time, my love. I will tell you about my habit, and maybe some of you recognize this, because we were just talking about this, of feeling like I needed to be a part of everything. I noticed that I felt like I needed to be a part of everything, or being without, or being left out, because when I was a child, my father really, I believe to this right now, when I was younger, probably was not the same belief, but right now, my belief is that he was so scared of us getting hurt and was aware of how unsupervised he was as a child that he like overdid it. He locked us in the house. Like, he worked graveyard and he would come home at 8 or 9 and then he would sleep till 3 in the afternoon and then get up, have some dinner. Or he actually started his own business and he would have to go to business. So often my brother and I were alone all the time. And I took on that responsibility because I saw how hard my dad was working. So I realized with me always being trapped inside, at least what it felt like, and we weren't allowed to have friends over. We weren't, like, especially the summers were so hard. So once I got, like, so-called free from that lifestyle. And again, I don't look at it anymore as, because I've done the shadow work, that it was something against me. I understand why my dad did it. I'm protective of my children right now. And looking at it from my perspective as an adult now, I realize that he did it out of love. So I've let go of that. If I need to self-care and try to do it for me, I get called self-centered or selfish. Ah, good job, Britt. Very good. So she said that anytime that she does take care of herself, somebody's showing up and saying that she's selfish. So the habit has probably been, you know what? I shouldn't even do that because someone's going to think this, or because I don't deserve this, because people have told me, you know, it's selfish to take care of yourself. So I'm going to believe what other people are saying. And yes, Britt, I want you to hear those words. That is literally what you're saying to yourself. I'm just going to believe what they said is true. I accept that as truth, and I'm keeping that as truth. But the Shama Mama is here to remind you. Have you stopped and said, wait, is that my truth? Let me see. Usually it's been my mother or family members. Yes, because it's probably many females in your life. This is a very common feeling for all females. Nikki will tell you in here, my lovely husband, he tells me all the time, you know, you got to put more time in for yourself. And I'm like, I'm trying. And he's like, there's no trying. You just need to do it. You need to make better boundaries, like he's telling you right here. Or you need to, you know, figure out a difference in your schedule and how to make this work. And he has motivated me to make even more time for myself. So my self time isn't the only time I lock myself in the bathroom. And when I go into the bathroom, you know, I make sure I sing my heart out in the shower and have me time, and everyone's going to hear it. That's how I fill up my cup. And it's actually really good for your vagus nerve if you have a cold shower going and singing. I loved when my neurologist taught me that, and it's now what I stick with to help calm my nervous system so I'm not stuck in fight or flight mode. What is something you do to take care of yourself, Britt? Let's go into the emotions right here. Why she's thinking about that. This is the next layer of the shadow work that you haven't looked at in a while. And Nikki and I have a method that we are calling the Janek method, Jen and Nikki together, and it's tea time. And I've written down in here, T equals your thoughts, E equals emotions, A equals your actions. How do these control your emotions? So we're working really hard on this with our children right now and ourselves. And so that's why we're staying on it with you guys as well. Like, we're 100% honest, like, it's tracking your thoughts is some work. So when you're feeling overwhelmed, oh, I love that, eating candles, playlist, cold shower, sing and cry sometimes. Yes, I have done the ugly cry in the shower too, head against the wall. But we got to get it out somehow, brother. So I sing and I love going outside to feel the fresh air and be able to breathe. I love that. That's so good. Hey, Josh, how you doing, buddy? I saw that you called yesterday and I did not. I was just getting back to work yesterday because I've been sick and I was going to give you a call tomorrow. So I'm so glad you're here. Nikki is too. I always walk around barefoot to be connected to nature. Yes, grounding. Did you know you can ground yourself just by putting your feet on Mother Earth and let it, the magnetic field pull that those negative ions out of you? Man, just 10, 15 minutes a day. Woo, let me kick my stand here. 10, 15 minutes a day. That will make a huge difference in your life. Please, please, please follow our friend Aiden here. What else do we got? Guilt makes me feel I'm suffocating, so letting out the bad air helps. Yes. So, oh, great. I want to hear about it, buddy. So the part of feeling guilty, it doesn't matter how it shows up. For all of us, it shows up that way too. I shouldn't be taking care of myself. I should be up and moving right now. Do you realize the United States is pretty much the only country that works this way? That has this like fear that we feel like we need to be moving all the time. And we constantly need to be working or we're worthless. Thank you, Britt. Have you noticed that? When I noticed that and I started learning about other cultures and seeing how much slower they move. And not feeling like I'm in a rush. I'm sorry, there's something in my nose and it's bugging me. I feel like I need to blow. I might step out of the camera for a second. Let's see. I can't believe how uncomfortable we get in silence. Let's try that for a minute. Let's sit here together. Let's see if we can go through a whole minute in silence and stick with each other and just see what we pick up. So everybody who's in here with me right now, or if you're outside of this and you're just watching, I want you to do this with me. We're going to sit together for 1 minute and we're going to see how we can let that awkwardness just slip right on by. And for you introverts, I'm pretty sure this is going to be really, really easy for you. But for us extroverts or ambiverts, this might be a little harder, okay? But test yourself here, okay? So we're going to do it. I'll just put on a 1 minute timer. 0 hours. Okay. So I got it on 1 minute, okay? And start. There you go. Congratulations. You took a whole minute for yourself right now. Even being here and learning some information about your shadow work. Working on the shadow work journal together right now, if you're just joining us. Giving yourself that time. Well, I like to call it tea time. Where we work on our thoughts, our emotions, and our actions. If you don't like how something's happening in your life right now, then you need to track it down to what your emotion's feeling right now. Because it's in the shadows and you haven't been paying attention. And it's not telling you to go hurt somebody. It's telling you to wake up. It's not telling you to push it down deeper. It's telling you to wake up. Do the work. Get it. We don't need this nonsense anymore. Let's move. Let's go. Are you listening to it? Because if you're not, then you're going into protection mode. And it's either to protect yourself. So you build such a thick wall that you just become a giant you-know-what to everybody. Or mm-mm. Right? Because you're not letting anybody in there, are you? Thank you so much for the gifts. I don't think so. Nope. Or you're the opposite where you go and protect everyone else but yourself. Identify with either of those? Yep, that means you got some shadow work. If you see that protection in you. Next one, controlling bodily functions. Have stomach issues? Do you burp a lot? Do you twitch? I'm so exhausted. I still feel fresh trauma and I haven't really dug deep enough. Britt, you're working on it right now. And I want you to recognize that you are doing the work. Right now, where you're at with however far you've come, I want you to see where you've come from. Have you moved at all in a new direction? Even when you feel like you've had setbacks. Have you moved at all into the right direction? I want you to really look at that. I love that. I don't like talking about but I love to help others, more of a listener. And, you know, Amanda, with having, I'm in an ambivert, I'm in between an extrovert and introvert. And when I'm in my ambivert mode, I am so thankful for my husband, who is an introvert, who can listen really well. Because that's what I need. And then if I look at it in the astrology way, as a Gemini rising, I need to be able to talk things through. I need to be able to hear it out loud. That's why we need each other. That's why each one of us have a certain way that we act and that we feel more comfortable with it. We just have to be aware, like if I'm having a conversation with Amanda here and I'm listening to her, and like I have a client and she might be in here, I know, I'm not sure, but I have a client that is even more of an introvert than Nikki is. Like, I wouldn't be surprised if she's 100% of an introvert. But she will sit in our meeting and I will say something and talk to her about something. And all I'll see is this. My extrovert self, anybody else feel uncomfortable if I was just sitting there going, you just told me something, you know, maybe even profound, maybe said something you've never heard of before. And, or maybe you're saying it to me and I'm just sitting here going like this. This is what I call the introvert phase. Any of you introverts out there, you're probably laughing out loud right now because you've been told that, you know, you don't pay attention. You show no emotion. Have any of these ever been your identity? This is where we have to learn about one another, right? When I see Nikki doing this, I say, I need the answer out loud. I'm pretty sure you're thinking it in your head, but I need to hear it out loud because then I know you heard me and my extrovert self can like calm down. Does anybody else notice this about themselves? The brick wall emotion, yes. It's probably good that you show emotion in face because I read faces too. And luckily I can read energy. So like when I'm watching energy shift around people, like they'll start one way with me in a meeting and I kind of can see where they're at. And usually if you've had time with me, you know, I'll call it out on you. And I'm like, ah, I see a lot of yellow around you today. It looks like something you're having an argument with yourself. So you're debating at least something inside you right now. And that ego wants to take it one way and the will wants to do something else with it. So it looks like you're probably working on that conversation. They'll be like, yes. And then as we're working through that, then I'll notice their colors move. I notice the thing changing. So like even right now with Amanda, I can see blue. I see a lot of blue around your energy. And that energy is telling me that you are really working how to use your voice. Now, you're like, oh, that's obvious. Well, most of us focus on how we're talking outwardly. It's either one or the other extreme. Either you're focusing on how to talk to others and you think that's the problem, but really it's the reflection of it. You got to work on talking to yourself. You got to start finding out where that balance is. Or it's the opposite. You're doing all the self-talk inside, but you haven't practiced it outside yet. My son says he sees blue as well. So when you're doing that, Amanda, I want you to start noticing when you're feeling aggravated with somebody around you and you feel like, I just got to tell them this. First, slow down and look how you're communicating to yourself about it. Do you actually feel in peace with what you're about to say? Or is it coming from an ego space? An ego space meaning, you know, you never listen to me and you don't even care about me. Or like, it could be anything like that. Like even just that feeling, right? If you start picking up on that, I call that Mr. Blowfish. He's popping up, the ego saying, there's a problem here. You don't feel loved. You don't feel respected. You don't feel seen. So what are you going to do about it? And a lot of times with us not knowing, because we haven't done the shadow work, like I'm telling you guys right here, right? This comes down to like belief, which is the next level right here. Her belief or anybody else that this connects with, this was certainly me for a long time. That's why I can see it so clearly, is that your belief is that no one's ever cared about you or loved you the way that you love you. And I want you to think about that, because do you really love you? Are you in love with every inch of you? And if you're honest with yourself, you might feel a space that is saying, I don't know. I don't know about this yet. And that's okay. That's okay. Give it time. And you know, the funny thing is once we release the control of having to know the answer right now, to not knowing something inside us yet, that we need to sit with it for a little bit. When the shamans taught me that, you know, before you respond to anything, give it 7 days. I want to even the sad parts or moody parts. I know I'm deserving of outside love, the way I love myself. That's why yes, exactly. Get it so comfortable with that feeling of like, you know what? If I love the way that I look today and I love the way that, you know, I like, sometimes it's not even about my look. Sometimes it's about how much I got accomplished that day. That just makes me feel like so excited. Like my son was saying today, who's right here, we were going on a walk and he said, you know, isn't it funny that people focus on, I got to lose that much weight. I got to lose this much weight. I got to lose all this weight. Right. And then they lose 2 pounds and they're like, oh, it's not enough. He's like, but I've noticed, you know, cause he gained some weight during the pandemic. He got some, lung issues. And then top of it was right at hormone season for him really. So he was being really hard on himself, but he noticed once he lost a couple pounds, he felt better. And he focused on that and just kept going. And he, every time he looks in the mirror, he's like, wow, I lost some more weight. I've even noticed that in myself. And I said, you're so right that we focus more on that it's not enough, instead of saying, wow, I can notice the 2 pounds off of me. Wow, now I'm up to 5 pounds. I'm doing so good. Even if it takes a month, why do we have to rush everything? And it's especially bad in the States. This is what we've been raised with. We got to rewire these brains of ours, ladies and gentlemen. We got to stop beating up on ourselves. We got to change those beliefs. That brings us to desires. Are you acknowledging your desires? Yes, we expect instant gratification. So because of that, if you even do acknowledge your desire, Are you rushing it for that instant gratification? And then when it doesn't show up fast enough, do you give up on yourself? Or if you're hoping somebody else will do with it, do you give up on that person and then find somebody new? Instead of turning to yourself. My desire is not to be a good dad, but my girlfriend doesn't implement any of my education or experience in. Well, Aiden, is this your biological child? Not to try to get too personal here. Because I'll just wait till you answer that question, because we can go two directions with that. Yes, Amanda, compassion for ourselves is what we need to build up. I'm telling you, once you start loving yourself for who you truly are, you're going to start noticing the other things don't bother you anymore. The only way they can bother you is if you believe it at some level. Again, with that belief. Okay. Yes, she deemed me as that an equal partner, but doesn't treat me as equal. Okay, so I just want to, like, Nikki's going to, like, probably laugh at this right now, because my Gemini self, I always have to look at both perspectives. I'm not saying that this is for sure her perspective, but I just want to point out that I'm a mom of three boys, okay? And I, at the beginning with Nikki, had a hard time with him coming in and helping with any of that, because of all the other trauma that I have been through, I understand, my children went through with me. I know them, and I believe that I know them better than anybody else inside and out. So when someone comes in, even with the good intention to want to help, and I don't know what she's been through, but I would assume it's been some type of trauma, whether it was in her childhood or with the marriage, or, you know, maybe she lost the father of the children. She used to appreciate, but now she calls me a know-it-all. Okay. So what she's showing you right now, what I see anyways, just from banking off of my own experience, is that she doesn't believe, there's something that she doesn't believe around this. So maybe she had a stepdad who said he was going to show up, and then he didn't actually, he ended up failing her and leaving her. So there's always this part, not that she sits here and goes, well, you're just going to leave me like everyone else. But I'm saying there's a subconscious level of hers that is, maybe she hasn't even talked to. Maybe she's not even aware of it, because it's sitting in this shadow area. It's sitting in this dark unconscious area of saying that I don't know that it's true until I see it. And I had to explain this to Nikki too. I had to tell him that, you know, I hear you telling me you're never going to leave me, and I hear you promising all these things. And I do. I really, really want to believe it. And every day you make me believe it more and more. But it's like you're chipping away parts of me for 13 years that couldn't believe that anything, probably even longer than 13 years. But just from what I went through with my children's father, where I felt like this is always going to be a struggle, and I have to take care of me and I have to take care of my boys. We come first. Yes, call out his. Yes. I've got out of my way every day for a year. She used to enjoy my experience and knowledge, and now she hates it. Hates my opinion. So she's clearly telling you right now she doesn't want your opinion. You need to let her see it for herself. So maybe if it's not around for a while and she realizes she misses it, she might come and ask your opinion for something. But there's something around trust that's been broken. And it's not, again, it may not, it's not that it's your fault, and it's not that it's right either. But you might be the first person in her life that actually gives her this space to figure it out. That's a huge part. Do you respond to DMs? I want to see about a session with you because I have so many questions. Yes, I do. So message me. I will not send out a DM to you. There are people that impersonate me out there. So, but if you reach out to me, I will respond to you. And the links are in my bio. So I would love to work with you, Britt. So I'm glad. I know you giving advice. Let's look at your shadow here too, Aiden. Let's look at your shadow for a second. Let's forget her shadow of lack of trust and feeling of safety. I would say are the two big shadows that she has popping up for her that, you know, she can look at. We can probably find that in her astrology chart. I can do a session with her and listen to her and see what she's repeating over and over again. But if she's repeating to you right now that I don't want to hear it, then back off. And when she says, why aren't you doing this anymore? Saying, you told me to stop. Let her notice it. Now, she might still not take that as a good answer, right? Like when Nikki and I were working through some major shadows. And if you're not going to be in a relationship with her and you've realized she's like this right here, she's not open to learning or healing from her trauma. Anybody else hears your sign? And again, it has nothing to do with her being a good person or a bad person. It's that what I said with that question came out earlier is you cannot change anybody that's not ready to change. That was the hardest lesson for me to learn about my children's father. I still to this day, you know, like when I hear him joking around with the boys and hearing his sense of humor and hearing about the adventures he goes on, I love that part about him. It's the part where he disconnects and doesn't want to work on himself and blames everybody else for his problems that I have a problem with. We all have problems. Nobody's getting scot-free in this world. Absolutely not. I don't care if you have a ton of money or no money at all. Every single person has problems. All of us have the unsolved mysteries of the shadow world inside us. Because most of us, except for like these Gen Alphas, like, I don't know, I was watching some videos. I might make a video about it tomorrow. But watching these Gen Alphas talk at like the age of 5, I'm like, what are they, like a 40-year-old woman inside a 5-year-old body? Like their mannerisms, the way they communicate so clearly. That's the work of the generations, ladies and gentlemen. All of our hard work is starting to show up in the next generation. And they're so smart. So smart. So, let me see what you're saying. She's going to see me backing off and ignoring her. I just don't have energy to give. Exactly. Don't tell me you love me and want to me to be down and treat me. Yes, those are your boundaries. So now you're telling all of us, Aiden, just so you know, all of us soul family in here, all 56 plus whatever's on the outside, we're holding you accountable to that. Those are your boundaries. That is your truth. You deserve to be treated with kindness, even if you are holding space. You know, every single one of us, even Nikki and I, that's why we come on here and we tell you what we're working through. We're not hiding anything from you, you know? And like a big thing that Nikki and I've worked on between our relationship is he has, one, he's introvert. Two, he's ADHD. He's so creative and he will get lost in his ways. And sometimes he'll even ask me a question and then I'm answering and then I realize he's on the or he's doing the, and I don't know whether he's with me right now or he's somewhere else. So it used to really aggravate me. Like everyone will tell you in this house that I used to get frustrated as all heck. My Aries moon will come out real fast of like, did you hear me? Like why? Like during the pandemic with my children, I started talking to the wall. I literally said I might as well just be talking to this wall right now because it's probably the only thing that's listening to me. But what was the thing that I was saying over and over again out loud? Nobody listens to me. So when you turn that around, I don't listen to me. Every single thing that you're complaining about and you're saying nobody or they do it, turn it back on yourself. Turn it back on yourself. That's where these shadows are going to pop up and you're going to either get defensive or you're going to go, oh, I see. I was blaming. I was denying. I was lying. Again, if you're just coming in right now, we're working on the shadow work journal. And we're uncovering things in our unconscious right now, in the shadows. I let her struggle and deal with tantrums that could have been prevented. Yeah, she's gone. Some of us just are stubborn. I mean, I always think, like, God, our angels, our ancestors, whoever's watching us, whatever perspective you have, I have to say it. They're probably like, are you kidding me? You're doing this again? It is so obvious. It's right there. It's like they're probably yelling at the TV screen or whatever how they see us, right? Just like when we're yelling at the TV, we know where this is going. Hey, thank you so much for being here. I haven't been live for a while, but I'm so glad you're here. My son wants to try to go live. I don't know if he can, but I will see. He wanted me to try this. I sent him an invitation, and he's going to be so excited about this. He was right. Ooh, that means we can do it with the Janekin family. See if I can help. Oh, there we go. Mm-hmm. See? So you don't have access. Can't turn on camera because doesn't have access to join without video. Okay. It's like, why does it even approve it? Okay, so we tried. It didn't work, buddy. Okay. Traumatized, used by wigging it. Is he a mirror? Yes. Let me try this again. He wants to try again. Because I think he wants to say what we've been having this conversation at home. Try talking, bud.
Hello.
I heard you.
I know. That's what he told. That's what I told him. And he's like, no, it says I can. So it's not working, buddy. Okay. We'll get you on the live soon because he wants to connect with all of you guys too. Oh, you hear him? I don't hear him. Is it because I have my volume down? Oh, my volume was down. Okay. Let's try that again. Okay. There we go. Now I hear you.
What's up?
Okay, so what's the information you want to tell them connected to this and the shadow work? What have you, 13-year-old self, been connecting through this information? We've been having this conversation a lot too at home, right?
Yeah, it's like something I've been working through personally with myself.
Why don't you tell them about that?
Like it's like something, if you can't fix somebody by yourself, or if they don't want to be fixed, like you just gotta let them like figure it out on their own sometimes. And if they come asking for help, you should think about it. And if you see that they actually want help, then you should help them. But if they just don't want your help right now, then just don't help them.
And do you think it's because they don't want help, or
they don't know how to accept the help?
Yeah, maybe they don't think they need help, because again, that lie that we all tell ourselves is this is the way it's always been done.
Yeah. True.
Yeah, this is the way my family has always done it. This is the way. I don't know any other way. It's too scary to try it the other way, right?
Yeah.
So if that is true for you, right, how have you been learning this with your brothers? Because you have two little brothers, and you know, what do you do with those little brothers? Like when they're not doing, when you're like, nope, you're going to get in trouble. What have you been teaching like yourself of set of the reaction that you are using right now? What's the new way you're doing it?
Yeah. So just like, if they don't want to hear what you're trying to say, then you just got to let them figure it out on their own, because some people just need to learn the lesson the hard way.
But how hard is it for you to like do that right now? Like, say your little brother comes over and he's poking you while you're playing a game.
Yeah, it's hard to have self like resistance to not go and try to fix them yourself. Like, because I want to fix people and just be like, hey, bro, you shouldn't do that. And they're like, oh, whatever, go away. And I just, it's hard for me to not help them because, you know, I love them and I want to give them the best, like, way to, in the easiest way to learn. But I knew personally for myself, it took me, like, I didn't listen to other people. I had to figure it out by myself a lot.
Now, I want to point out, because right here, Aiden, I'm trying to prevent a child I love from being traumatized the way that I was. Aiden, I want to point out to you, this is exactly why I'm teaching my son right now, because he was also traumatized as a child. And as many of us have some form of traumatization, like something happened in our lives. I have never met a soul in this world that hasn't had something happen to them. Okay. But the way that it happened to you created fear, which means you don't want this child to ever feel that fear. You don't want anyone to ever feel that fear. But is it your job to fix everything? Is it your job? Because who's to say that kid isn't going to go through something that teaches him a skill that actually changes the whole world in a positive way? Because look at all of us here. All of us have been through something major. Every single one of us. And when we go through that and we come out the side that you're on right now, where you still have love in your heart, where you still have passion, where you still care about a child being hurt, who's to say if you can't fix it at that moment and you've done your best, that it isn't the path that they're supposed to be on right now? We have no idea why our souls are going through what they're going through when we're children. 0 to 7, we're just sitting there in that observation mode. We're sitting there like, all right, people pick me up, they feed me. Well, mom does this, so I kind of want to try doing it like that too. Okay, that feels good. Yeah. Oh, I don't like that. No, don't like the way that feels. Oh, you know, oh, that's my dad, and he treats my mom like this, so that must be the way that the world, you know, treats women too. Oh, yeah, I see other things in the world, like movies and shows, and I see people treating this way in public where they hurt each other. So this must just be normal. This is all the information our little baby minds are taking in from 0 to 7. Then, which again is where we can get to the blaming, denying, and lying, right? If you as a child told your mother that I don't like the way that feels, and she says, well, it's your fault. You're the one not listening. It's your problem, right? Then you're going to go, oh, it's my problem. My mom said it was my problem. So then when you do something like that to step in and someone's sitting there, you know, and you're telling them, hey, that's not the way you do it. You're doing it wrong. And you realize that you're saying the same words that your parents said to you, even when you said you would never do it at all. It's because you decided to try it out instead of reviewing it beforehand. You didn't review the message that was sent to you as a child and decide whether you still believe that or not. Have you been able to find peace with those in your life? Exactly, and I don't want her to think that's what love is. You know what love is? Love is when someone shows up. Love is sometimes holding space for someone and not saying a word at all. Just letting them cry. Sometimes love means, like I was explaining this to my 10-year-old, he has friends that, you know, hormones are raging with these 10-year-olds and they're got their opinions and their little sassy attitudes. And I'm just like, wow, was I this way at 10, right? And, you know, the whole she doesn't want to be around me and she's calling me a weirdo, but I have fun with her brother and, you know, like, or any other like little things that are coming up in his life right now. And I asked him, and I'm going to ask you this too. What did you imagine friendships would be like as a child? Did you imagine? Yeah, I saw that. did you imagine that all friendships were going to be perfect? Did you imagine that it was all going to be, you know, sunshine and butterflies and rainbows? Or were you aware, and have you, if not, are you aware now as I'm bringing it up to you, that life doesn't always work that way? We need challenges. Maybe a friend doesn't see something that's happening, or a loved one doesn't see how they're treating others, because people keep enabling them and don't speak up and do not set healthy boundaries around them and say, I can't do this anymore. I imagine it people holding me accountable and telling me when I'm doing something wrong, hurtful. Yeah. We don't want to be wrong, because we've been told, like, not knowing something is bad, that you're dumb. It's not true. It's another lie we tell ourselves. There's only so much information you know. I know during the pandemic, when I was helping my kids with school, there was a lot of things in like English and math that I do not remember retaining in school at all. But I'm sure other people in my class did. We all get the information when we need the information. I tell her that she's not a bad mom, that she knows a lot, but there's some areas that could be improved on. Yeah, I bet you she knows that already. And she doesn't need another person telling her that. Just like you don't need another person to tell you you got things to work on. How can you show her that love in a different way? And sometimes it's sitting back. And sometimes showing love is watching people fall on their face. And being there when they get up. And not saying, I told you so, for all you out there. Sometimes, if they think they know what they're doing, then you just need to agree with it. All right, I did my part. I think I see something here, but I could be wrong. Be open for change. Sometimes I assume something's going to go that way because it reminds me of something that happened in my life. And then I'm like, but if I just let it flow and I don't interrupt, I'm like, whoa. I went a whole other direction than I thought it was going to go. Exactly, Jen. Lead by example. So that's the last part of the shadow stuff, is attachment to things, thoughts, and feelings. You are attached to feeling like life doesn't always go the way you want. You are attached to that feeling. And if you realize that and go, there is another way that I can try to get out of this, and it's probably going to feel weird and uncomfortable at first because I have to let go of control. Jen said I just have to let it flow. Let me ask you right now, how many things have showed up in your life right now that you thought it was going to go one way and you finally said, you know what, never mind. Like, I realized this the other day when I was like trying to visualize the red light to turn green, and it felt like it was taking forever. So I was totally having like a 5-year-old self of just like closing my eyes and like, I have the willpower to change this if I believe it. Right? And then Nikki asked me a question and we got into this conversation, and then next thing I know, I was already on the main part of the road and I don't even remember the light turning green. It was once I let go of the control that things just naturally flowed, and then I wasn't sitting there with anxiety and having stress anymore, and it worked out. It worked out. I just need to trust. There's so many examples I can give, and I hope you guys have some examples too, if you think about it, of when I thought it was going to go one way. Like, I thought life was going to get much harder by leaving the domestic violent relationship I was in because I didn't have any money to my name. I was a stay-at-home mom. And how was I going to like get a job that pays me pretty much the same price to put 3 kids in a daycare? And I don't know if I'm going to get child support, like all of these fears that just went through my head. And something was like, just go, Just go. You'll figure it out. Just trust. And I swear to God, that night I saw Jesus in front of me saying, do you trust me? I was like, I don't know what else to trust right now. And that right there, I don't know. I just trust. I just, there's just a feeling. Like today I had to go to the doctor for something on my foot. And it's been there for like 4 weeks. And I was like, you know what? I don't want to be one of those people where like I saw it the whole time and I just kept ignoring it and wonder if it is something that I need to get looked at. You know, what's it going to, the worst thing it's going to be is like, nope, you know, it just looks like you got a spider bite and it's still taking a long time to heal or something, right? I went down, and when I was going down there, you know, the cancer question popped up for a second because my grandmother has skin cancer, and I'm like, is it skin cancer? You know, and there was a part of me like, I don't know. But there was another part of me that I'm starting to discover in myself going, yeah, you're fine. But it's good that you're getting checked out. You know, it'll just double agree with what we're already thinking. Like, I felt very calm about it. And when I walked out, I was like, see, I can start trusting myself. Because we've talked with Aiden and Amanda so far tonight, and I promise you, it's about taking care of yourself. Because once you start doing that, the logic comes in. The light gets shined onto it. The filters start being taken off. Some call it mask. You start seeing things more clearly. You then are more analytical. Right? You could say this is more the feminine energy sometimes, and this is the masculine energy. We're straight to the point. Why are we sitting here and suffering for so long when we just have to make a decision not to do this anymore and know that it's going to take work to get out of it, but it's going to be worth it in the end. So no different than when you studied for that test and you got an A on it and you're like, see, all that hard work paid off. If she can't respect her own child, how do I expect her to respect me? Is she even respecting herself? And if she's your partner, if she's your partner, she's reflecting back to you something you don't respect yourself either. You're all just reflecting that to each other. So one of you's got to start doing the work. If you don't feel safe in this relationship, I mean, if the child is really not safe, then that's a whole nother step you need to take. You need to decide, is it just the typical stuff like all of us, you know, a lot of kids are going through that right now because parents didn't get raised emotionally and weren't taught how to deal with their feelings. That's why we're all sitting here together and reviewing this right now. And the economy has tripled, you know, in gas, food, everything that we rely on. Things, you know, the government's going and shut down next week, and that's going to take away money for other people. Oh, I do. That's why we fight, because I stand up for myself. You know what? Sometimes standing up for yourself is finding out the new solution on your own. Because you've already told all of us that she doesn't want to do the work. Why? That is the honest truth right there. Maya Angelou, once they show you who they are, believe it. You know, and then we like to put, well, then it's over forever. I wonder if it's just over for a couple months. Maybe you take a pause and you just, you know, I had to go figure out, you just said that she doesn't live with you. Make stronger boundaries and say, you know what, I got to get my thoughts together and figure out what makes me happy again. Because I'm not feeling happiness anymore. So I'm going to put me in charge this time. And I really hope you go do your work too. And then, you know, if you want to talk in a couple months, you can check in with me and see if I'm ready. But at this point, I'm not going to be in a relationship with anyone because you've pointed out something that I need to work on. You've shown me that I need to love me, that I need to go figure out what makes me happy. I need to go take time for me. I told her I'm not coming up to see her much anymore. If at all, she's 81 miles away, too far. Yeah, look at this, Aiden, you know it. You know. The problem is you're lying to yourself. You're sitting here saying she's lying to herself, but you're lying to yourself too. But I want it so bad, but I want love so bad. You want love like this? This is what you've been fighting for? I think who else thinks Aiden deserves better? But Aiden's not going to get someone who fights for him if he's not going to fight for himself. Am I right? Aiden, did someone not show up for you as a kid? I'm asking you. And I hope if you don't feel comfortable talking about this on the live, I want you to. Yeah, literally everyone. Okay. Do you see the wound that you're healing with this child? Do you still feel like you're always pushed to the side and never mattered? Do you still feel that way? I was always pushed to the side. I never mattered. You put that in the past tense. Do you really believe that, or is that still a belief right now? Good. Then those are the people you need to be around right now until you attract someone who understands this. You have to do this for you. I'm cheering on for you. Everybody else in here is cheering for you too. We don't have to know each other to hope that somebody else has good in this world. This is for you. And yes, it's probably going to hurt. And you're probably going to feel like you're failing that kid because now you're doing what you said you wouldn't do because others did this to you. Isn't that what you're fighting right now? Because you might think you know the answer. Well, that child needs, and as a medium here, who sees souls and sees spirits and has worked as a shaman and works with, you know, the other side of the world with seeing spirit and energy and learning about shadows. I mean, shadows are only the things we hide inside us. Let me tell you, I can see shadows around people and attached to things that where there's a wound that was not healed. Often we get assigned these to our soul when we have not accomplished something from another lifetime, especially if we did, you know what, to ourselves in another lifetime. If we ended too soon, we ended our contract without fulfilling the rest of our contract. Life is going to feel a little tougher this time because that shadow is going to be right there by your side. And it's going to be there reminding you what you are going to accomplish and win in this lifetime. We all have a mission. How can you be part of God's army if that's one thing that you connect to? How can you be a part of this planet right now and breathing right now and not think that you have a purpose on this planet? Now, with that kid, with that child, if you truly believe this child is being abused, this is a personal choice you need to make on yourself, for yourself. We'll hold the space for you and help you work through this. Thank you, Amanda. I don't feel like I'm failing her kid. She loves me so much. But if you leave, are you going to feel that way? And if the child is truly being abused, like really abused, not, you know, if she's got close, I'll tell you right now, the basic level that I don't agree with, but with the state and something we're going to work on with social justice with our nonprofit One Source Action is just because a kid has a blanket, clothes, and a bed does not mean they're being taken care of. Look at how many of us were raised that way and we still don't feel safe in this world and we still don't feel loved in this world. That's something we need to look at as a society. And realize when children learn this lesson at a young age, they're going to become the adults that are constantly looking for attention, that are constantly feeling overwhelmed, that are constantly having high anxiety, that are going to feel depressed because they don't know how to deal with their emotions. No one ever took the time. If you feel that this child, if you leave and you go choose you, is getting abused even more than that. Because I'm telling you, that's the state's bottom line. No matter what state, I work with state agencies and the bottom line, they will most likely just come in and say, nope, they don't really care about the mental abuse. They don't realize the impact of mental abuse. So if you're wanting to report and it's not past that, which again, I'm saying that it does need to be more than that, but realize what you can do authentically, you know, and legally is not going to be much. Now, if the child is actually being starved or hurt in any other way, then that is your job to step up. Deemed her fit. Okay, see? So your next choice, as we're working through this and talking through this right now, as we are analytically looking at this right now so we can make movement, because we went through the unconscious stuff, we brought it up to the surface, now we're looking at it from the light, the conscious perspective. The analytical part here is where you need to sit now and go, is it within my waistband and not taking energy from my battery to be there for this child? Do I have it within me? If the answer is no, then you're hurting the child emotionally. Because if you can't be there for the child because you are emotionally drained, which brings up your anxiety and your depression, that's all depression and anxiety, in my opinion, as someone who has suffered with this, I've realized it's when my battery is empty and I don't have much more to give. The anxiety and depression are just sitting there telling me to slow down. And it's time to heal something and deal with something. It's time to bring the shadow work to the surface. And as soon as I do, it's so interesting how it goes away. It just goes away. And sometimes it doesn't take very long to work through. Sometimes you get the quickest, like, oh my, it's right there. Right? So Aiden, if she's already been deemed, can you sustain this? We're not looking at sustainability. Like, this is something I'm talking about with our nonprofit One Source Action, that we're not learning just how to be like use products in this planet that are going to sustain the planet. We also need to learn how to sustain ourselves. We need to find that balance. And we can't be there for every person. You're talking to a mother of three children that went through hell as children. I mean, they're still kids, but when they were really little. That young man that you just heard on here, who's already processing at 13. You know what? Sometimes you just, there's nothing you can do. And that's just the fact. And we don't like that because we feel out of control and we want to fix it. That's normal. It's okay. But you don't have to sit in that. You don't have to feel guilty. You don't have to feel bad. Hi, Scuds. You don't need to do this anymore. It's okay to choose you. Because you know what happens when you start choosing you and you start building that battery? That movement that puts you into this space of understanding that I got to do this to keep my sanity, to keep me feeling safe in this world. I have to answer to my inner child as well. And when you do that, you start attracting the people that understand this. You're starting to understand that. That's the only reason why any of you are here with me right now and working on this wonderful book. And again, if you're interested in getting the shadow work journal, please get it right there. And you can work on it each time we come live until we're done with it. And I'm going to be posting this on our, I'll restream it tomorrow on our private Facebook group. If you go on the link in my bio, not only can you book time with me, but you'll see Jenick, J-E-N-I-C-K-H, Jen and Nikki combined. And you'll see pages. Follow our Facebook group, and this video will be on there tomorrow. So if you need to process it again, or you want to invite other people to the group that you think will benefit this, invite them, have them watch the video. So that way we're going to try to keep this information as fresh as we can so that we can all go through this together. And this can be your little notebook, your little book to work on it when I'm not around, when you feel like you're having a panic attack or you feel like you don't know the answer, when I know you do. I know you know the answers. And we're proving it right now. Okay. Haven't been called to open it, really. Well, at least you're kind of observing what we're doing right now. Okay, Rebecca, I'm glad you got it. Okay, so we create that movement and we start choosing ourselves. And you know what? Decision making becomes much clearer. And then short-term memory starts clearing up. We start remembering what we need to do for ourselves. We find the willpower and we use critical thinking. We make controlled decisions. We slow down and we look and we go, is that really what I want to do? I don't know if I really want to do that. Okay? So the wound mapping, everybody write these magical words down. We're going to work on wound mapping. Okay? Wound mapping. Write down a piece of paper or open this page in the journal. Again, if you are interested in getting this journal, there it is, okay? Wound mapping, the exercise. We're all going to do this together. Yes, you do need a notebook, Miss Amanda. Okay, identify your inner child wound based on the attributes listed on the next page. Okay, so we're going to identify the inner child wound. I have a video that I just posted before I went live where I talk about this, and I have a message for your inner child. So make sure you do that after this live feed, because I'm going to get off here shortly. Okay, so it'll be there for you when you need tech in, and I'm too busy being a mom or an entrepreneur to get on, but I'm there for you in that way. Okay, and again, join that Facebook group. We're growing every day, and Nikki and I put little blogs on there every day. We put fun videos. It's a great way for all of us to connect. I saw Amanda interacting on there today and many others, and I just love seeing it. Okay, so abandonment, guilt, trust, and neglect are the four major kinds of inner child wounds. You may find one or more that align with your persona. Anybody else notice abandonment issues? Just check it off if it's true for you. Guilt. We already talked about that tonight, didn't we talk about that? Right now, our beautiful friend in here, part of our soul family, opened up saying he's having a hard time with his relationship and he doesn't want to leave the child before. Aiden is definitely working in and out through guilt right now, and abandonment issues, and also trust issues. And it's not just about that child, it's about his inner child. So I'm kind of giving you the answer there, Aiden. And anybody else that's working through this, I know I had to work through all these and still have layers that I'm working on. And neglect are the four major kinds of inner child. You don't want to neglect those issues, right? You may find one or more that align with your persona, okay? So why? It hurts to be offended or harmed. None of us want to be hurt or harmed. What person in this world loves being picked on? Nope, not me anyways, especially at a young age. We just think it's normal. We've talked about that tonight, right? This is an exercise that allows you to pinpoint emotional wounds from your early childhood. These wounds are what cause certain behaviors and habitual thoughts that do not serve us. By identifying your inner child wounds, you will hold more space for compassion towards your humanness and provide a healthy foundation to begin your shadow work journey. Okay, so if you say yes to any of these, you are dealing with abandonment issues. Do you ever feel left out? Say yes or no in your journal or in your head. That's fine. Write it in the chat, whatever is your fancy. Okay, or like I said, grab this journal so you can do it along with us during the live feed. And if you're rewatching this on our page, I will think about how I'll get that link to you. I know there's a way. I'll figure it out. Okay, so anyways, yes to any of these. Do you feel left out? Okay. Do you have a fear of being left behind? Do you have a fear of being left behind? How about hate being alone? Anybody not like being alone? And I'm telling you right now, the answer is yes for you. Right now, if you get out of a relationship and you're in a new relationship, within a month or so. Even if it's a friendship. You find something else to distract yourself because you hate being alone. Good job, Aiden. Aiden, you're seeing some of your self-work that you've done here. Congratulations. You used to not like being alone, and now you love being alone. That's you doing your self-work and learning more about yourself and identifying those things by going through the shadow work. Very proud of you. How many of you codependent? I'll raise my hand. That was me. That was me. I'm less and less codependent now. Like, I'm like, well, I tried. Good luck. See you another day. Anybody else? I enjoy my me time very much, so too now. By the way, make sure you're drinking your water right now. The Schumann is like blacked out, which to me, we're going through another shift right now. And I think it's because from an astrology perspective, Pluto is about to go direct. And it's going to start leaving the house of Capricorn and moving into Aquarian energy, which is the age of Aquarius, right? And lots of change is coming. Lots of change. So our bodies are kind of like, all right, we've done a lot of work, but we have nothing to anchor to. So if you have been kind of feeling a little out of it, like Nikki's sentence yesterday was like, I'm here, but I don't feel like I'm here. Having any heartburn, upset stomach right now, any of those, that is normal. Is the cat just barged his way right in. He's like, I am here and I have something to say. but any of you, I've been having a lot of heartburn too. That's one of the symptoms I have found. And I eat like, I've been eating so healthy and all this gut stuff. And I'm like, where is this coming from? I haven't had heartburn in forever. And then when I looked at the Schumann residence today, which I did a report on that on our Janik. If you haven't seen it today, I wrote a little blog about that in our Janik family page on Facebook. You can also just look it up, Janik and family, and say, I want to be a part of the soul family and we'll accept you with love and just follow the rules and we all should be good. But heartburn is another. So make sure you're drinking that water. Make sure you're slowing down when you need to. If you don't feel steady, it's because you're ready to step into this new space and the universe is like, hold on one second. We got a little work to do here. And we still have 5 retrogrades right now. Like I said, it's going to be going down to 4 here soon with Pluto moving direct. I believe it's April. Wow. October 22nd goes fully direct and it'll start moving back to the house of Aquarius. So we're all moving. We're all doing work. And again, if you want to learn more about this book, Time With Me, it says retrograde special when you go to link in my bio. $44 right now. That is half the price I normally charge to do astrology work. So I will break down your chart. I will send you how these retrogrades are showing up in your life. And I'm going to send you questions to go deeper to figure out how you can bring those shadows to the surface right now instead of like walking into the same issue over and over again. Okay, so codependent, do you threaten to leave? That's it. I don't want to be here anymore. That's it. I'm over. This one was a classic one of mine. I'm over this. I'm done. I'm not really done. I'm not done because for some reason I care too much. Anybody else recognize this? What is the retrograde? It's true because, okay. Retrograde, right now we have Saturn that's retrograde, which is the planet. I have notes somewhere. Where did I put that other phone? That is a really good question. I wonder if it fell. I don't know where I put my other phone. I had it here earlier. Oh, it's right in front of me. It would smash me if I wasn't looking for it. Yes, heartburn, I think is coming more from the Schumann residence, which is Earth's heartbeat. Here, we'll all take a look at it as a family right now and see what's going on. This is what it looked like this morning, by the way. See how it's all blacked out? That means we have nothing to connect to or anchor to. Like, Earth's magnetic field is a little out of sorts right now, which how can our energy connect to that? Like, that's not our normal fun. So let's see what it's at right now, shall we? All right, so we got a little energy that started, but look, it blacked out. So it's like, I feel like it's like the new form of breath, and Pluto directs us in a whole new direction. Pluto is it's the planet that starts its new beginnings, and we've been hearing about this age of Aquarius since the 60s, and here it is, here it comes. And the last time Pluto was in Aquarius was during the Revolutionary War, the French Revolution. It was a revolution, baby. So revolution is coming, whether we like it or not. And I really, my personal belief is this has to do with a spiritual revolution and our thoughts. It's how we think and how we connect to one another that way. So the Schumann is showing that it normally picks up all the electricity across Earth, like the lightning strikes and everything, and it's got a rhythm kind of to it, and they call it Earth's heartbeat. And then when the sun decides to play games with it, that's all lots of fun. This is an app. It is called the Schumann Residence app. I got it right there. Schumann Residence. I have an iPhone. It might look different on an Android, but just download that and you can keep track of it. My family and I will start feeling off or different, and science has actually reported, a lot of humans reporting this, that they just feel off, like, you know, they just don't feel right. And so many people are saying at the same time, and they notice when there's these dips or high spikes, and especially when there's a solar flare, because NASA shows that radiation comes onto the Earth and then it spreads across the planet, and it hits us all at different times. So we can feel tired, we can feel dehydrated. So that's why I'm saying make sure you keep on that water, okay? So back to my abandonment people. Normally attract emotionally unavailable people. Anybody recognize this inside themselves? And I want you to realize lots of highs and lows for you right now. I want you to recognize how you're looking at that right now. When I hear that, I want to say, congratulations. You're going with the flow. You're feeling the heartbeat. You're moving through it. It's like going for a hike. You go down, you go up the hill, and it's really hard. It's a workout. Let's not lie. You know, today we've been going on a little hike almost every day now for the last 4 days, and every time we're going up the uphill, I'm like, oh, right? But that's life. We're going uphill. It's working new muscles. We're learning new things. We're getting healthier, right? Then we get to the top and we can enjoy the view for a little bit. Those are the highs. And sometimes those highs come really fast and really slow, right? But are you slowing down to see what part you're in right now and appreciating and learning everything that's coming from that? Okay. So when you're doing that, I'm going to tell you, it's really hard to attract those unemotional people, because if they see you doing a work, they're going to say, stay clear. This person does their work and that's just crazy. So I don't want to do it. I like when they run. I like when they're like, I don't want to have you intimidate me, or whatever feeling they have with me. I mean, I'd rather them talk to me about it and see if maybe we have a connection or whatever before they judge. But at the same time, if they're overwhelmed by it, I don't want to waste my time with it anymore. I love myself enough now to know that I only want people around me that do their work, that love themselves. They're doing the best they can every day. And each day they're getting better and better. And the days that they fall back, they learn from it and they grow even faster. Those are the people I want in my life. Those are my boundaries. And I'm noticing other people don't show up anymore. And that is fine by me. And that's where I want you to get. So you got to let go of these abandonment issues. And the abandonment wound comes from something in your childhood that happened to you at some point. Did your mom and dad get a divorce? Was there domestic violence? Was there SA? Was there something that showed up in your life? Or maybe your parents were just never home. My parents were never home, but I know they loved me. They were working two jobs each just to pay all the bills. So it wasn't that I didn't feel loved, but I also didn't feel like I could talk about my feelings because of that decision. But now that you're an adult, why do you think they went to the bar? Do you think that they were sitting home, taking care of themselves and learning about their shadow work and really excited about doing their work? Or do you think they went to the bar because it felt overwhelming and they didn't know how to process their emotions, and that was the best way to numb it? Because no one told them or showed them another way. to help them, the only thing I'm going to change with this one, right here, I'm going to pin that because we're close from my perspective. I used to think this way too, but now I say to help them heal your pain. To help them, you need to help your pain. Because I'll tell you right now, when I made boundaries with my mom, oh my God, just scared the crap out of me. Is there cheese in there?
Fried bread.
Thank you. Fried bread, but it's hot, so I'll put it down. It was like I was in a zone and somebody just popped out of the corner of my eye and I got really scared. So I'm good. Okay, so back to to help them heal your pain. My beautiful mother, from my perspective, has a hard time standing up for herself. And when I was a child, this was very hard for me to watch. Especially, you know, millennial baby being raised with women's rights. And, you know, for me, it was more normal than it was for her. It was more normal for me than it was for my grandmother and so on, right? And I couldn't understand. It took me a long time to figure this out too, ladies and gentlemen. It did not just take me like a couple minutes. Like, I'm talking years. I'm talking at least 7 years of actually consciously being aware of it. And I guess the rest of my life just going through it, right? Exactly. And Aiden, you probably reflect a lot of this with your mom because you recognized it. And I recognize this too with my mother. Like, how can you let him speak to you this way? And guess what my affirmation was, ladies and gentlemen? And maybe this was yours too, right? As I was dealing with my abandonment issues. My abandonment issue and my affirmation that I said to myself all the time is, I will never be like you. Has anyone else ever said that about one of their parents? I will never be like you. I want you to be honest with me. Have you ever thought of that with one of your parents before? Yes. There we go. Look, we all have this in common. But now, have you recognized this part in you yet? That you did become a version of that. Maybe not as extreme, but you did become a version of that. Yes. There you go, Aiden. Right? And for those of you, if this is a new concept, don't worry. You just haven't had this tool supplied for you. And that's why we're here tonight. Yeah. Yeah. It never came to my attention before either until I realized when I was in the domestic violence relationship. I didn't even know what domestic violence meant. Like, I showed up to the it was a social service to see if they could help me get a place because I did not want to live with my parents. Congratulations, Aiden, again. You know, he's realizing that he did become, he said, yeah, and in the worst ways, I became just like them when I realized that I had to make a change. And his first one, I'm sure there's many changes, but right here he said, it's why I stopped drinking. All I ever saw was abuse to my mom, so I thought it was normal. Exactly. How many of you thought abuse was normal? That's just the way it is. Again, what is that? That's our thought, which then creates the emotion of lack of, which then creates the action of either abusing ourselves or abusing others. Yeah, you can be an abuser too. So that brings us to guilt wound. Say yes to any of these, right? Feeling sorry or bad about something. I don't know if Nikki Scorpio is still in here, but what has he taught all of us? To stop saying sorry for every little thing. This comes from the guilt wound. Stop it. Stop it. If you are feeling sorry for yourself or feeling bad about something you have already identified that you can't control, stop feeling guilty. Let it go. It's something you can't control. But what you can control is your thought. You can say, you know what? I've done the best I can. I do need to take care of myself. And we're going to leave it at that. And it's going to feel hard. It's going to feel weird. But it's time to let it go. The next one. What does it say? Use it. Don't like to ask for things. Excuse me. It's kind of the running joke in our family. My lovely husband does not have a problem speaking up for himself at all. I know he's also worked really hard on that. But we were at Walmart and we were standing there for like 10 minutes and we noticed there was like 5 blinking lights in the self-serve area and everybody's just like looking around to see if someone will notice that they're looking at them. And Nikki's like, really? This is what we're going to do about it? And so our laughing joke in the family is when he goes, excuse me. And he starts shouting. And it was so funny because the guy, that like the closest person with a blue vest on, looks at him and then literally walks the other way. And he's like, hey, no, I'm talking to you. Is anyone going to help anyone over here? We've been standing here forever. And you could see like probably half of the people were like embarrassed. They don't want to ask for things. They don't ask for help. Why? Why do we do that to ourselves? Why is it a bad thing to ask for help? Oh, was that from when you were a child? And when you asked for help, they told you, you should know this already. Why are you taking so long to understand this? Knock it off. God, you're so stupid. Self-reflection. When parents are doing that, look at yourself right now if you're a parent, if you get frustrated. Why don't you understand this already? Did you stop for a second and go, wait, maybe they don't understand it from this perspective. Maybe I need to show them another perspective because we know there's many different perspectives in this world. And why am I forcing my kid to fit in a box? I don't like it when somebody did it to me. Maybe they just need to see it a different way. Anybody? So, uses guilt to manipulate. Guess what? You're not going to like this one. Because, of course, the normal, like, feeling, oh, I guess, if you have to go, you know, instead of outright just saying, you know what, I really would like you to stay. Or, man, I wish I was invited to that. Nobody ever invites me to anything. Yeah, maybe next time you can think of me. Why do we talk that way? How about you call it? You say, you know what? It really hurts my feelings. Like, I feel like we're friends. And everyone that you've been doing these other things with that, you know, I feel like I could be a part of too. Nobody even asked me if I want to be a part of it. I'm just saying, like, it would be nice if I got asked too. Otherwise, maybe we shouldn't be in this friendship. Are you doing that? Guilt wound. Is afraid to set boundaries. No, I set boundaries. No, I totally set boundaries. Oh, did you now, huh? Did you? So when you said you were going to leave, did you leave? Okay, if you didn't do it the first time, did you do the second time you promised it to yourself when you made that boundary? How about now? How long is it going to take you to actually set those boundaries? And I mean set them. Let the cement set it is in. And you know what? If you want to change them later, pull the cement out. You can always change. So what's the fear of trying? Just wondering. All right. Normally attracts people who make them feel guilty. You're never on time. Why you always gotta dress like that? Man, don't you know how to do your makeup? Hello from Australia. Thank you so much for being here. And thank you for letting us know where you are. Why don't the rest of you? I know we got Aiden here from Florida. Just say a quick hello to everybody. Meet the soul family. And again, if you're interested in doing your shadow work and you want to do this through astrology, which is a whole nother way that I could do it. I could look at your chart and see exactly what shadows are coming up. So we can figure out these abandonment wounds. We can figure out the guilt wound. We can figure out the trust wound. And we can figure out the neglect wound. Right? Boston in the house. I'm scared to be labeled as needy. So what makes you feel like you're needy, Mike? Yeah, we're going to dig into Mike now. But if you want me to dig into you personally, you know, just to show you what I'm seeing, another perspective doesn't mean it's right or wrong, but just from some experience here, from being an emotional intelligence life coach, to also being a shaman and working with many medicine tribes around this world and learning about shadow work. I'm a certified Reiki master teacher. I'm also an entrepreneur and have my own company and help run other companies, and an environmental consultant and a business consultant. And what did I mention? I'm a founder of a nonprofit. I got a lot on my plate, people. So if I can do this, you can do this too. Being dependent and indecisive makes you feel needy. Okay, so when I look into that, what I see, Mike, is, oh, thank you, Kathy. Yeah, and you know, I have a man that supports me for being that independent woman, too. He just loves it. Being dependent tells me, if you're afraid of being dependent, were you more of a cuddly child? Did you like hanging out with everybody? And did you have a parent that did not enjoy that so much? Because what would we say, ladies and gentlemen, that being dependent is connected to? What wound have we already talked about that calls that out? Hates being alone. Thank you so much for the gifts. And make sure you're signed up for my Shama Mama Squad and get those fun stickers and get the free 15 minutes, which is really 30 minutes. Because I give you 30 minutes on my calendar regardless, because I'm a talker and I want to hear what you have to say. So I'm going to let you talk for like 20 minutes and then I'm going to take the last 10 to make sure we get some homework to you, so that way you have somewhere to stop. So definitely join the Shama Mama Squad. That's probably the cheapest way that you can get time with me and start working on your wounds. And then you get to have the fun stickers and everything in here too. My mom is smoother and my smothering, and my dad was an alcoholic in his world. Aha. So there is the parent. You're a blessing. It takes one to know one. Okay. So your father did not accept you for who you were. And he showed you that by being absent. Am I right? Good evening. Am I right, Mike? So, Mike, I see a mix of orange and yellow around you, too. And that's telling me, so the orange is your sacral. It's where you connect to others. And when I see orange like that, you have a really, like, it's like a darker orange around you, which tells me that you actually really, even if you don't show this now, the deepest part of you actually really, really likes being with people and sharing, you know, like watching a movie together, going out to dinner, learning more about each other, having those. Great. Okay. So that orange in you needs to be more balanced. We need to get it closer to like what we normally call orange, not a bright orange, but like orange. And that means you're really looking for it right now. Like, again, there can be this part of you where you're in the back of the room and not telling anybody this or showing this, which is actually what you're showing the world. You're showing yourself disconnected that way. So that's why it's like burning out. That's why it's getting dark, because it's like, all I want this, and I'm not being mean to anybody. I'm not hurting anybody. Why doesn't anybody see me? Sometimes we got to step up and we got to move into it. So when I see that yellow coming in with this, and that moves you into your will and your ego, Mike, it's telling me you got to find a balance, and you've been having a fight with this inside you for a while. And it's because of that father wound. And how many times were you told to stop talking as a child? Did you notice that? Love that. Ancestors. As Mike's getting ready to answer this, I'm going to go to the trust wounds. Because Mike's got some trust issues. So let's see if he identifies any of this. Again, we have the shadow work journal that we are working on right now as a soul family. Welcome to the Shama Mama Show. This is where you can get the book and join us or take notes. I used to cry a lot on my own until they took my door away. And then you really had to be quiet, didn't you? And yes, it's they. I just want to point that out. It's they. Because mom didn't stand up for herself. And dad did what made him feel safe and happy in this world. He didn't slow down to ask you why you were being so vocal and crying and why you were hurting. Mike, you're not alone. You deserve to slow down and let those tears out. And you also need to look to see whether you're still really feeling that way. Do you, and if you are still feeling that way, and mom and dad aren't in your life every day, and you're still allowing this behavior, now it's up to you. You have to parent yourself. You need to turn to yourself and say, why? Why do you not feel like you are worth being heard? Because your door is not taken away anymore, buddy. You are in control of your future right now. And you deserve to have somebody that really listens to you. Even when you cry. When I hear my husband cry, it tears me up inside. Because he screams so loud sometimes when that pain comes to the surface. And some of you have seen him cry. Yeah, aren't we all coaching ourselves through life? But we have a lot to share with one another, right? If we all share a little bit of what we've learned and that we're figuring out, that's how we get smarter as a society. So I'm sharing what I've learned to help you, and I know you'll help someone too. I know you will. Otherwise, I wouldn't be on here for 3 hours talking to you for free. Because I believe everyone deserves to get this information. And like I said, if you want to go deeper in this, go to that link. Book some time with me. So Mike, we're going to start coaching ourselves and saying, I am worth it. You see someone you want to have a conversation with and they seem interested. You're going to take a deep breath. You're going to remember Shama Mama's words right now. And you're going to say, I am worth it. I'm interested in this. And the worst that's going to happen is the person's like, freak, go away. Right. And if you, you know, if that's the worst that happens to you today, like, you'll be fine. You know that. But what if it doesn't go that way? I wonder if you start a really good conversation and you learn so much from it. You got this. I know you do. So, is afraid of being hurt is part of that trust issue. Because you've been hurt so many times. And to let people in one more time, it's not easy. But every time I opened myself up again, I realize I didn't get as hurt as bad this time because each time I learned more and more and I got through it better. So it made it less scary. Thank you for the gift. Don't trust yourself. You don't trust yourself. I don't know what I want. But you just told, you know how many clients will sit there and tell me what they want, and then they'll finish it with a but or, you know, maybe. They don't really believe in themselves. They're not doing it. Good job, Mike. I'm proud of you. You're doing a good job. Find ways to not trust people. This is a big one with trust issues. Finding a problem with every single thing. I have a client right now that it has been very hard to work with them because they find a problem with every single thing. But then once I started learning about this client's past and how many things have just shown up in this person's life over and over again to show them they can't trust anybody, no wonder they're flipping out about every little thing. But are you going to continue to live that way? Are you going to start catching it and start trusting at least one thing? And why can't that be yourself? Why can't you start with that? Feels insecure and needs a lot of external validation. Now, that's a funny thing, too, because lots of times it shows up as when someone says, oh, my God, you're so beautiful. And you're like, okay. The soul needs that information. The only problem is you're denying it. You're not accepting that someone in this world thinks you're beautiful. Someone in this world thinks you're funny. Somebody in this world just thinks you are the you know what. Why is that so hard to believe that there's not one person out of all the people on this planet that think you're amazing? I mean, there's got to be more than one. So that lie we tell ourselves, ooh, that's another big one. Doesn't feel safe. Like I was talking to Aiden about earlier with his girlfriend. She does not feel safe. I will call that out now. And she's probably hasn't felt safe in a long time, if ever. So the deeper that those wounds go, Aiden, the harder it's going to be for her to trust. And as all of us are saying in here, she has to be the one to choose to at least to start trusting. And yes, a lot of times in the honeymoon stage and the we're getting to know each other thing, that the honeymoon is a dream, right? It's what we want. It's the illusion that we're saying. I'm telling you right now, she didn't. It was attracted me to her. It's a mask. It's a mask. Do you know anything about her story? Because I bet you do. And if you know just a little bit, do any of the things that she's told you about show you how she does not trust in this world? I'm telling you, she might have had that mask on real good. But she has always had trust issues. If you want to prove me wrong, I always love a good debate. But I'm usually not right. It's not right. I'm usually not wrong about these things. Because I've been there. And also I've seen it a million times. Yeah, very normal to be too trusting. I trust everyone at the beginning. I had somebody that I let into my house 2 years ago because a dear friend of mine passed away. His brother was actually in here earlier. And the man took advantage of my whole family and decided to scream at us and yell at us and belittle us after I flew him out here to be at the funeral and let him stay at my home before he had to go back to save him money. I trusted because he was a friend of my friend. Didn't even know him. That's how trusting I used to be. I'll tell you right there, that was the last time. The last time. And it was amazing because my friend Christina, she does lunascopes. She, when I was going through studying astrology with her and she was teaching us how to be astrologers, I had missed a lot of classes because I was out on work. I do.